You spray color over your surface and it's everywhere. Sprays are so difficult to use and make such a mess. But I'm here to tell you that using sprays is easier than you think. Sprays are some of my favorite products to use in my art. And because I don't want you to miss out on the fun, I have a few simple solutions that might help you feel less frustration when using sprays. I know many of you are scared to use sprays because one, they make a mess, and two, they're very hard to control. Let's start with the messy part. There's two types of creators, those who love getting their hands dirty, like me, and those that don't. But why should you not enjoy using sprays? Because you can wear gloves or an apron. But if your concern is about your messy desk, then you can also use a cardboard box and create a spraying station. It is such a simple solution that will save you so much aggravation, and it's free. However, it is the second reason that is more common among people, as they're afraid to use sprays because they can't control the outcome. That's why I will be showing you simple solutions for common mistakes people often make with sprays. The first mistake is not shaking the bottle before using the sprays, because a lot of sprays are made of powdered pigments mixed with liquids. The powder sinks and settles at the bottom of the bottle, so when you use it without shaking, the color might be too light or diluted. The second problem people often face is clogging. We're so used to shaking things up and down, like when we shake a bottle of salad dressing, for example. But for certain sprays, this is detrimental, as shaking up and down can clog the spout, especially with the sprays that are made with powders. The powder travels up the spout and clogs it, preventing it from spraying. The best way to avoid this is to shake the bottle sideways and not up and down. If you need to unclog the sprays, you can soak them in warm water, and it is also recommended to clean the spout after every use. Another tip is to hold the bottle at a 45-degree angle when working on a flat surface. Imagine as if the spout, the mat, and your artwork form an imaginary triangle with a 90-degree angle on your surface. This angle is ergonomical as it ensures that the tube inside the bottle is touching the liquid. If you hold the spray horizontally or facing down, it will work only while you have liquid in your bottle. The thing I love about sprays is that you can cover a surface quickly and efficiently, like I'm doing here with these distress sprays in my art journal. But depending on the desired effect or coverage, there's different heights in which to hold the spray. So the triangle from before might be taller or shorter depending on how far you hold the spout. Holding it further up will cover a larger area but will also create a very light spray on your background, similar to airbrushing. Spraying at a closer range will give you a darker coverage but will look more like a circular shape. I usually vary between heights so I can get different effects in the background. If you want to add more layers to your background, then it's important to dry really well. You can even use a wipe to remove excess liquid. Once dry, you can add another layer like I'm doing with my mandala stencil. One of the biggest mistakes I usually make is spraying too much, especially through a stencil. When you're spraying through stencils, holding it further back and spraying less will give you a more precise look of the pattern. If you're too close or you spray too much, then the liquid might pool underneath the stencil and might distort the image. This takes practice, but eventually you get to learn what type of image you love best. I love it when the colors are bright and the stenciled image looks distressed, so I don't mind if it pulls a little under the stencil. I don't mind an imperfect image because perfection is overrated. The thing is that if you want to be able to control how much you add, you can start with a little bit at a time and then add more, as it's easier to add than to remove. And truthfully, nobody ever said you only have to use it as sprays. Opening the bottle and using the sprays as paints is one of the things I often do when I want to control the amount of color. I will either use the spout or dip a thin paintbrush into the bottle and use it on my artwork. You can also spray it on your mat to be used as paint or ink. You can even use a sponge dauber and blend the colors through a stencil to enhance the background pattern. Or you can use it to create splatters in the background by dipping the paintbrush into the liquid spray. I hope the tips I've shown you here today will help you feel confident when using sprays. But if you want to take it one step further, I want to show you how to combine sprays with other products such as paste or gesso. I have a video for you right here with a few mixed media tips to help you get started.